Hello, I'm Edward and welcome to WindowsReport.com. In this video, I will show you how to fix the system license violation error in Windows 10. The system license violation error can occur due to a few causes, such as the Windows system files corruption, either corruption Windows registry, damaged RAM, or faulty system drivers. But in this case, you can easily fix this error by following a few procedures that I will show you in this video. For a more detailed explanation and even more solutions, please check the article in the description below. The first solution is checking the hard drive. You can do that by entering the advanced startup. You'll do this by restarting your computer while holding the shift key. Then, in the new window, choose troubleshoot and then advanced options. Select Command Prompt from the list of options, and when the Command Prompt appears, enter the following lines and press Enter after each line in order to run it. bootrec.exe/rebuildbcd, bootrec.exe/fixmbr, and then bootrec.exe/fixboot. Some users are also suggesting that you need to run additional check disk commands as well. To perform these commands, you need to know drive letters for all your hard drive partitions. Then, in Command Prompt, you should enter the following, but remember to use the letters that match your hard drive partitions on your PC. chkdsk/r /c:// and chkdsk/r /d:// The letters are just an example, so keep in mind that you have to perform the check disk command for every hard drive partition that you have. Then, restart your computer and check if the issue is resolved. Another solution can be running the BSOD troubleshooter. To do that, you have to click the start button in the lower left corner and just write Settings. Then press Enter. Just go to the Update and Security section. Then select Troubleshoot from the menu on the left. Click the blue screen from the right pane and click Run the Troubleshooter. Follow the instructions on the screen to complete the troubleshooter. In case checking your hard drive didn't work out, you can always try the Microsoft built-in troubleshooter for the BSOD errors. This is probably the easiest solution for almost BSOD issue because it basically solves the problem for you. You can also run the DISM scan. You can do that by clicking the start button in the lower left corner, then writing CMD. Then right-click the command prompt and run as administrator. What you have to do now is type the following command and press Enter. DISM/online/cleanup-line-image/restore-health. All you have to do then is wait until the scan is finished, restart your computer and try updating again. There's also another way of running the DISM scan, and you can do that using the Windows installation media. You have to insert your Windows installation media, then again you have to click the start button in the lower left corner, write CMD and access the command prompt as an administrator. Then, in the command line, type the following commands and press Enter after each command. DISM/online/cleanup-line-image/scan-health. Then, DISM/online/cleanup-line-image/restore-health. Now, type the following command and press Enter. DISM/online/cleanup-line-image/restore-health/source:wim:1/limit-access. But make sure to change the X value with the letter of the mounted drive with the Windows 10 installation. After the procedure is finished, just restart your computer. Another solution can be installing a Windows optimizer. You could simply use a third-party tool to check your hard drives and detect and repair any issues on the spot without the hassle. The best part is that you will get to reclaim your system resources, free up precious disk space, and get more available memory to enjoy faster startup and loading times while you're at it. And another quick solution is finding and uninstalling the problematic applications. Sometimes certain applications can cause this error to appear, therefore it's crucial to find and remove those applications. It's worth mentioning that almost any application can cause the Windows 10 system license violation error, so you might have to do some more research before you try to find the problematic one. You should also know that recently installed or recently updated applications can cause this error too. Therefore, if you updated or installed any new app before the BSOD error started appearing, just uninstall it. One common cause for blue screen of death errors is your antivirus software. Almost any antivirus software can cause a BSOD error, so be sure to remove any third-party antivirus programs that you have installed. To completely remove an antivirus program, you should use a dedicated removal tool. Many security companies offer these tools for their software, so be sure to download one for your antivirus program. For more information and details, please check the article in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.